Hi there, I'm Katie, and today I'm joined by Becky James.
Hi, Katie.
Hello.
Today, Becky's going to show us this beautiful mini bookcase.
That's it.
Using the Roald Dahl collection. Now, what techniques are we going to be focusing on?
Well, what we're going to do is I'm going to show you how to make one of these little mini books. So I've got Charlie and the Chocolate Factory one here. And we're going to go through a number of pages. So we're going to use things like the new book page stamps. And I'm going to show you how to make little pockets and just some various other little bits and pieces that are all in here. And we're going to talk about, we're going to put the book together, and then I'm going to show talk to you about how the little bookcase was made.
Brilliant. I can't wait. Go. Fantastic.
Okay.
Right, Becky, what's the first thing we're going to do?
Right, well, the first thing we're going to do is make the cover of the book. Now, I don't know, Katie, if you want to have the book with you so you can...
Okay.
So we can show people bits and pieces of it as we're going along as well. Okay. So what I've already done is I've made my cover and I've scored it to give myself a little spine.
Okay.
Now, to fit all of these pages in, I think I've done a 0.75 inch spine, but it's dependent if you want to add less, obviously make it a bit narrower, more... make it a bit wider. And all I'm going to do is just fold these over. And I like to give them a good fold to make sure I've got nice creases there. And I use an X-cut fold scoring and creasing tool.
Mm-hmm.
So what I've got to cover it with is, this is the adhesive paper.
Oh yeah, that's brilliant.
It's lovely stuff. So obviously you've got your waxy paper there that sort of prevents it sticking all over the place, and it's a really nice and tacky,
that's good.
And I love the little splodges on
dots
this one.
Awesome, aren't they?
They are really colourful and bright.
Cool.
Now then, what I'm going to do, just in case I don't get this nice and central, because
this is plenty sticky, isn't
this
it?
It doesn't
need any more help.
Yeah, exactly.
So this is
exactly. So what I'm going to do, if I just pop a little bit of glue stick over there, should I need to, I can manoeuvre it around. I can pull that back.
Gives it a bit of slip.
It does, exactly. That's exactly what it does. I'll be fine for doing cutting it there. Right, so what I'm going to do, I'd like to give it a, whilst it's there, just give it a good... make sure that that's all nicely attached.
Lovely.
And right, next thing, I'm just going to snip those pieces in the corners.
Okay.
And also, what you want to do is to cut down either end of the spine as well.
Okay.
And this will make it just easier for sticking.
Oh, I see. Each of the folds on the spine.
Yeah, that's it. It'll just make it easier for covering.
Okay.
And right, all I'm going to do, pull them down. Now this does stick really nicely. It really sticks well. So just pop that down. If you want to, just get your creaser and just...
That's nice and sticky, because often this sort of chipboardy stuff is a little bit fibrous, isn't it?
Yeah.
Things don't always stick that well to it. So that
absolutely
shows how sticky that is.
Yeah. So what I've now done is, when I was doing this, I was trying to think of how we could make it look like a proper book, you know, how they have an inside here where you open it up and then...
Oh, yeah.
But I didn't want to have everything stuck directly onto the inside, onto the covers when you opened it up. So it has that feel of a nice little proper book.
Okay.
So what I've done is I've got three pieces which make up the inside cover.
Okay.
And two of them are the same, and they are just going to sit neatly between the edge and the spine like that. So they'll sit neatly like that.
So that's just like the size of your front, but obviously
that's
a little
it
bit smaller, so you have the board around the
that's
edge.
That's it, okay. Exactly. And then I've got another piece which is going to fit between those two.
Oh, I see, so it's going to go
exactly
on top of there.
When I'm doing this, I have to be honest with you, I found the permanent rollers really, really good for sticking everything down. They're really sturdy, so I would suggest using these. Again, if you want to manoeuvre it around a little bit, just put a bit of the stick it glue stick over.
Okay.
And that will be fine. I will make sure this is really clearly written up when I do it. So.
Yeah, we'll have all the instructions for Becky's project online at dreamcrafts.com, along with lists of everything she's used as well. So you can pop along to the website and have a little look so you don't miss any steps or any of the detail she's put into her project.
So there you go. We've got a lovely base for the book.
Perfect.
So what we're going to do is we're going to put our pages in the centre here, and now we're going to do the really fancy bits, and we're going to put all the pages together.
Fantastic.
And this is where I've pulled all this together from the Ultimate Decoupage Pack and some new little stamps we're going to have a look at in a second. Now, when you're popping this down, I'll just pop it onto your acrylic block. Make sure these little bits here are all centred as well.
Okay.
Because there are bits here that are just plain, so you need to make sure that they're stuck.
Because it's quite a big area, you don't want any sort of bubbles underneath.
And I'm going to just ink that up. So we're just inking up the around the edges. Turn it over. Pop it onto your card or your paper, and just.
And of course, these are clear stamps, so you can see exactly where you're stamping with your clear block, can't you? So you don't need a really big
card. And I'll tell you what's wonderful about these as well is that I found when I was stamping with them, really, sign of a really good stamp is, especially the clear stamp, is if the lines are really pristine, because clear stamps are a little bit squadgy. You don't always see really detailed stamps in.
Wow, I see what you mean.
But if you have a look at it, you can see they are so fine. So I've now got my character, which is Willy Wonka. You won't see him on here. You will when I've just stamped it. But he's sort of dancing about as he does.
He's got his little cane, hasn't he? Yeah,
that's it. So you can see just how beautiful. And then you just go and colour them as you see fit, really.
So this is the one you've coloured in?
Yeah.
So what have you done with him?
Well, I've used the Artiste watercolour pens. But also, basically, I've used them direct onto the paper, except for his face where I wanted a little bit of blush. But direct onto the paper, beautiful, bright colours. I think, you know, that's quite... You expect that of these images. But just to outline the book, I've actually gone around with just a little bit of yellow watercolour ink from the pens and just gone around, and it sort of just lifts it a bit off the page.
Yeah, so that gives it that sort of slow yellowed paper look, doesn't
exactly.
it?
Exactly. Now, this is one of the journaling tags.
Ah.
And what I've done is I've folded it in half.
Yeah.
And so I'm going to do exactly the same with this. Just line it up. In the toppers, one of the topper sheets, there's this nice big topper, which actually is really the story of when he finds his golden ticket.
Oh, wow.
So what I've done is folded that up, pop a little golden ticket on there so that I've got something to grab hold of.
Oh, fantastic.
And that is going to slot in there. This is a little a little sort of like buntingy sort of embellishment. And this is going to go in the pocket on the other side that we're going to create
so
when we put the next page on.
You've joined together.
Basically, I've got little bits and bobs that I found in the packs, stuck them onto some baker's twine with some hot melt glue so they're nice and securely stuck, a few buttons make a difference. There's a golden ticket there.
Some little sentiments.
So, next thing, all we're going to do, a little bit of glue on there, a little bit of hot melt glue, and I'm just going to stick the end through that. I'll just twizzle it around so it's all there, and there we go. That'll just stick nicely. Now, this page shows something else a little bit different with those book page stamps, and that is, in one of the decoupage designs, there is a little book page that's part of the decoupage design.
Okay.
And these fit perfectly within the stamped pages. And then I'm going to show you how to add a little spinning element to the last page. So we're going to do something a little bit different on the last page. So I've already made a little hole in the paper. You won't see it very well, but it's about here. And what I've done is I've stuck one of the phrases or one of the quotes onto the back of an old Brad here.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to pop that through there. And there are also the spinning candy canes work exactly the same that are in the decoupage pack. And open it up, just push it down to make sure it's nice and flat, and then away it goes, spins again. Just something a little quirky. So now when you're doing this, what you've got to make sure is that you don't get any glue anywhere that's going to stop the brad spinning round. Now, I need to, before I stick the back page right to the back, I need to add one little thing. And I'm a great lover of this kind of thing because I hate it when I can't find pages in diaries or stuff like that. So what I've done is I've made a little bookmark, which is actually going to sit so
lovely.
That you can sort of pop that into a page. Now, actually, funny enough, there are little, this is made from a little bookmark, which is within the decoupage pack.
Okay.
I've fed the ribbon through, popped a little bow on there. And I actually have made this ribbon a little bit long, so we can just trim a little bit of that off. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick that within the spine.
Oh, I see.
But I'm doing it now because I can see whether it'll... Yeah, that will sit flat on that page if I stick it down now.
You.
So there we go. And that's it. Right then. So now all we've got to do is to... join the back page to this cover here.
Mm-hmm.
Very simple again. Right, so now I'm going to just add a couple of little finishing touches. First of all, I love these. These are the little pockets.
Oh, yeah.
So if there's any favourite little quotes that you haven't managed to fit in your book or something like that out of the decoupage pack, you can just slot them in here.
That's nice.
And I've put a little topper of the Oompa Loompas on there. So there you go, just in the back there.
Brilliant.
You've got your little pocket. And then all we've got to do is finish by putting our title on the front so that when we've got the book at the front, we've got the imagery, we know who it is.
Yeah.
And then on the side, so that when we take it out of the bookcase, we've actually got on the spine the title of the
book.
That's
wonderful. It's such fun making your own little version of the books, isn't it?
It is. Now, the bookcase itself is actually an upcycled memo. No, you know the memo note boxes.
Oh, yeah.
Boxes.
You can see it goes down
that's
there.
That's
it,
it does, but I've covered it up a little
hidden
bit.
That a little
but
bit.
Actually, it's quite good because it helps you to
get your
hand in there. What I've done is I've covered each of the sides. Now, I've matted Willy Wonka's golden ticket because I just love the brightness and the yellow. You know, it's just such a lovely, bright coloured paper. Now, I wanted a more sturdy piece of card for it to mat onto, especially here where this bit was a little bit. It needed a bit of covering up. So that is actually the inside of the Ultimate Decoupage Pack because it's patterned and it's actually this pattern that's inside the Ultimate Decoupage Pack. And it's a bit more sturdy and a bit more rigid. So if you want to make something, you'll make a box or something like that, you can
that's
do with
the
one it.
To
it's
use,
fabulous.
Then. Brilliant.
Yeah? On the outside, on either side of them, I've chosen because, you know, you've got duplicates, a couple of each one. So I've been able to put the same quote on either side.
On both sides, yeah.
Bottom, we've got Craft Planet bead, wooden bead
They're
feet.
They're brilliant for feet, aren't
they? I've usually got about 3 or 4 packets of those floating around somewhere because I am always using them for things like feet and things when I want to do some alt-to-dark projects and stuff like that. Then on the top, we've got another one of them, which is one of the big round buttons. And here, we've actually popped some of the little phrases and sayings and things like that onto some wire coils, which I've made with some wire and by wrapping it around a piece of doweling.
Lovely.
And I've just glued it inside the bead
hole.
And then I've covered it up with just one, because it needs a little something to finish it off. And it's one of the little pom-poms cut off the rolled doll trim.
I love trims. It.
So there you go.
Oh,
very simple
fantastic.
To do.
Fantastic. That's wonderful. Well, I hope that's inspired you to get creating. If you've been making something or you're going to be making something in the next few days, why not upload it to your members gallery at docrafts.com or even share it on our Facebook page. We'd really love to see what you've been up to and we can pop over and leave you a comment as well. If you've got any questions at all about this or a technique that you might be interested in, why not drop us an email to tv@docrafts.com and we'll do our very best to answer it for you as well. In the meantime, thank you very much, Becky. It's been lovely to see you today, and happy crafting.